today we're going to do Leyland numbers.
Leyland numbers?
Which are really straightforward.
Have you heard of the Leyland Brothers?
No. Who are they?
They're in Australia. They used to have a TV show like in the 70s and 80s, and they'd just go on adventures around Australia and show you cool stuff.
Ask the Leyland Brothers is the name of this new series, and that's exactly what we'd like you to do. Ask us whatever it is you'd like to see. Right, Mo?
That's right, Mel.
When you say Leyland numbers, I think of the Leyland Brothers.
Well, there's two numbers, so...
There's two?
One for each, right? So, here's a Leyland number for you. Let me just... It's named after Paul Leyland, who's an Oxford.
Oh, I see. The Leyland Brothers were Mike and Mal.
Not Paul.
No.
If I've got two numbers, x and y, a Leyland number is x to the power y plus y to the power x. The only condition on this is that x and y must be bigger than 1. That's my only condition.
They can't be 1.
No, they can't be 1. So 1 has got to be less than y, and by convention, you say that y is less than or equal to x. Because it's x to the power y plus y to the power x, if you'd just be double counting when the other way around. So you, just by convention, you pick one to be smaller than or equal to the other. What's the first few numbers? Well, if I just sort of have x and y here, and then we just say what the Leyland number is, well, so the first one is going to be, if y and x have to be bigger than 1, the first thing they can be is 2. So if they're each equal to 2, then the Leyland number is 2 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 2, and that's 4 plus 4, which is 8. And now what am I doing? I'm saying y is always less than or equal to x. So if I let x be 3 and y be 2, then it's 3 to the power 2 plus 2 to the power 3. So this is equal to 9 plus 8, which is 17. You can just go through them. I mean, you can just you just build them up. You've got 32, and then we've got 54, and we've got 57, and you've got 100, and they just go on. So, but the particular class of numbers that I believe are quite of interest to people, of course, are the primes.
It's a long way on a day like today, middle of summer. Certainly takes it out of you. No, we're nearly there now, so we'll carry on.
Although this is recreational maths at its best, that it's, you know, where you just go and have some play around with the numbers, I think this technique is actually used to try and actually determine as a way of determining whether something's a primes or not. And because there's basically just this nice combination of x to the y plus y to the x. So the particular class that are of interest are Leyland primes. Not just your generic Leyland number, but your Leyland prime, which prime numbers made out of this combination. We've met our first one. 17 is our first Leyland prime, and it's, of course, 3 squared plus 2 cubed. And then they're not that frequent, right? So 593 is made up of 9 squared plus 2 to the power 9. That's a prime. And then we've got 32993, that's made up of 15 squared plus 2 to the power 15, and you can go on, right? 209-7593 is made up of 21 squared plus 2 to the power 21. And in fact, so we're one of the biggest, right? Up to November of 2012, the largest prime.
Largest Leyland prime.
Largest Leyland prime, yes, considerably smaller than the large prime, was the following one. But just the way it works, right, the way it breaks down is so neat, is 5122 to the power 6753 plus, of course, then it's 6753 to the power 5122. And this is a number which has a mere 25,050 digits.
You going to write it out for us?
Got any more paper? But let's not waste effort on that one. Why don't we go to the one which was discovered in December of 2012, which superseded it, and it was made up of 8656 to the power 2929 plus 2929 to the power 8656. And this is a number that consists of 30,000 digits. So you've got the interest just because they're fun things to play with, and but they are used as a diagnostic to try and help determine whether something's likely to be a primed or not, using because of the fact that it splits into this x to the y plus y to the x. It's an additional tool that people make use of,
nice.
Which is quite nice.
Nice.
Yeah.
Much more interesting than the Leyland Brothers.
And if there's anything you'd like to know about, don't forget to ask the Leyland Brothers. Write to Post Office Box 900, Newcastle, New South Wales 23000. Don't forget, Newcastle, Post Office Box 900.